Today, in this video, I will be analyzing annual rainfall data. As here we have rainfall data of 30 years. So today we will compute these all problems. The return period and probability of occurrence for the observed data. We will calculating the for this all observed data. And number B is that probability of rainfall equal to or greater than the highest rainfall. These all question I will be solving today. And we will be lasting in last I will be plotting a graph between rainfall versus return period. Let us start. So first, for calculation of return period and probability, what I will do, let us see. So I will be arranging these all given data in the descending order, and I will be assigning the rank to the recorded events. So I will be assigning rank these I have done manually. Now we will calculate probability. For the calculation of probability, I will be using Weibull formula. That is equal to m by n plus 1, where this small m is equal to rank and capital N is equal to 30 years, as we have a record of 30 years. So we will be calculating probability. So first put equal to sign, then C4 divided by 31. Press equal to sign. Press equal to sign. C5 divided by 31. We don't need to put formula again and again. I have put formula in two case only. I will be selecting this, and with this is I will be pasting. You can see we calculated the probability for all the recorded events. Now I will be calculating the return period. So for the return period, for the return period, we know the formula T is equal to 1 by P. That is capital T equal to 1 by P. We need to do just reciprocal of column F. So what I will be doing? 1 by F4. Put equal to sign first, press enter sign. And again put formula equal to 1 by F. We don't need to put formula again and again. Just what we will do, we will select, we will drag to get the return period for all the recorded events. As we got the return period for the all recorded events, you can see. Now, so already we have completed our first problem, the return period and probability of occurrence for the observed data. We have calculated. Now I will be plotting a graph between rainfall versus return period. I will be solving this problem at last, B problem. First, let us do C problem. So plot a graph between rainfall versus return period. So return period should be on x-axis. return period. We will form another table, return period. We will just copy and paste. Annual rainfall. In mm. We have to just copy and paste. Return period here, from here we have to copy. And here we will be copying annual rainfall data from here. Let us copy. Now here we need to paste. As we have completed the table for the inserting of the graph, but we know the rainfall magnitude is plotted against the corresponding return period on a semi-log paper. Now, so we will be selecting these two data and we will be inserting a graph for this. See how I am doing. So this should be on semi-log scale. Here we have to tick logarithm scale, close it. And we can give trend line also. See, add trend line logarithmic. If we want display equation, take it. If you want display R square value on chart, take it, close it. This is our required graph. This is our required plot. We have completed C number question also. Now we will be discussing probability of rainfall equal to or greater than the highest rainfall recorded station M. We will be solving this. So let us see how we are solving this. So probability of rainfall equal to or greater than the highest rainfall recorded station M. From the above table, the highest rainfall recorded is equal to 1244, as we have already seen there. For that rainfall probability we calculated above, we got as 0.032. Return period, that is t is equal to 1 by p, we already calculated above. Now probability of occurring once in 10 successive years is given by, we know this formula, substituting n will be equal to 10 and we are wanting once time, so r will be equal to 1. So 10 c1 p1 q9, q is non-occurrence of the event. So after substituting we got this is our required answer. And probability of occurring twice in 10 successive years, so n will remain same, but r will vary. R now will be equal to 2. Again, substituting that in that formula only, we got we obtained as 0.0355. These are our final results. So in this way, we solve such type of problem. If you have any query, please put comment in comment.